We turned 30 this year at Neighborhood Housing Services. Yeah, thank you. As a part of our 30th year celebration, we agreed to do the dinner thing at Paramount Pictures, who was our host in May, and then this event. And then we do 3 events a month in the neighborhood, so we're a little crazy.
NHS is hosting a neighborhood symposium, and we are excited because it's all focused on sustainability, where there's jobs, transit, economic development, health, housing, all those pieces that make a neighborhood great. We're talking about it today, and we're excited. We have a lot of fun families and experts in their fields here to share great information.
The Neighborhood Housing Services has created this Neighborhood Sustainability Symposium. And they've invited people from all over the city of Los Angeles, county of Los Angeles, to bring their interesting and different perspectives on how are we going to work together as a community to make sure that our neighborhoods are great and greater as we move on.
I'm here at the LA Neighborhood Housing Services annual event, their Neighborhood Housing Sustainability Conference. It's an excellent conference, and they had some great food giveaways. Fresh fruit.
We're giving away free fruit, the fruit trees.
I have vanilla mango, my favorite.
7 free shade trees that people qualify for, and also our shade tree program where we actually will plant a 15-gallon tree in the front of the property, and it's all free through the city of Los Angeles.
Lots of different opportunities to get something that's more in your own wheelhouse in terms of advocacy, different panel sessions, and so they brought panelists from different walks of life, with different perspectives on something similar for different neighborhoods to work together. There's been a couple of different panel sessions that you could choose from, several different workshops, and either learn about or interact.
I think it's an excellent opportunity for community-based organizations and corporations that serve communities to provide information about how we can sustain our neighborhoods, keep them affordable, keep housing opportunities available for low-income people in particular, and a lot of information as well.
This is so helpful. Very, very helpful for us, especially like, you know, I see for me, from us as a small business, and then for the first-time home buyer, it's really a very good help. And all the booths and everything is really like very informative. Everything is like, it's very helpful, especially for me. I'm so excited and so like overwhelming. I just go around and get some more information, and then later I'm gonna attend the first-time home buyer.
We have 10 different workshops today, all focused on sustainability topics.
We throw away our resources, just like we waste rain. You get the message out to the youth by going to the youth and taking it to them. And once you put somebody in the soil, once a kid sees that you can plant a seed and all of a sudden you have food.
It's just making something continue. And it's making sure it's solid enough and started up enough that it can continue on, and that it doesn't run out of money or run out of resource. It's like roadways. You don't want to go outside and find out that the road's no longer there and it's dirt now. It's the same thing with our schools, same with health, same with economic development and job creation. We need all those pieces working right all the time.
Change can't happen without people coming together, without community coming together in the same room and putting their heads together and finding out how they're going to organize and become activated to make a change that's sustainable and meaningful.
There's a lot of knowledge here, and I want people to empower themselves with this knowledge and go out and change this community, change their lives, and change the lives of people around them. It's possible. That would be fantastic to have this turn into a community of makers, artisans that just create from stuff that's already here. We throw away all, we cut down trees, and what do? We put them in landfills instead of making furniture out of them, instead of building soil out of them. You could literally put those trees back into the ground and they will decompose and they will give you some of the best soil that you could ever imagine. Plants live, just like soil lives. So you're putting organisms and bacteria in your body when you eat, and they become you. That's real. You are what you eat is real. I want people to change their lives by changing their food.
Our attendees are a mix today of residents, business people, some government folks, and certainly a number of specialists in these different fields focused around health, transit, wealth and asset building. There's some people here who are advocates around gentrification not happening in our neighborhood. So it's a pretty eclectic group of folks. And then just everyday people read about it and said, what are they talking about? I'm going over.
NHS as an organization has shown their heart and soul over and over again in my neighborhood. The need for affordable housing and for caring about your community and the way that they've done that and they've led by doing, I think is very impressive, and I'm grateful for their energy and activity.
NHS, we're always grateful. That's our word, it's not gonna change. We asked people to come and they did. So when you get people who've been in their fields for 20, 30 years and all they think about is health and how to make it better for people, and then they team up with someone who thinks only about bus systems and how to make sure people can get on them to get to the hospital, it's nice because now the people who don't always talk to each other are coming together today to share, not only with the families who attend, but with each other. For people who didn't make it to the symposium, the conversation goes on. We don't ever stop talking or doing. So join the process. Join the movement. Get engaged. Get involved, because home matters.